Hello everyone, this is Gary Templeton. I'm going to show you how to transform continuous variables to normal in SPSS. I have a data set here containing a variable of interest, market value of a company, and there are two steps involved with transformation to normal. And the first step is to go to transform. We're going to rank cases. You see their market value is selected. I want to make sure that I rank using the fractional rank and nothing else. Continue. Press OK. And we created a variable, and I'll show you that variable. Here it is right here. Market value, and you see that it's a fractional rank. Second step is to go to transform compute variable. Hey, see, I already have it loaded. What I do is I select inverse distribution function, inverse DF, scroll down to IDF normal. You would click on this and press the up arrow. I can even do this for you. There. And then we want to name the variable norm market value, as you see, is our name. You just type that in. Okay, and you see in our function we have three arguments. The first is going to be the result of step one, this fractional rank. You put the variable name there. The second is going to be the series mean, which I'm going to copy and paste from Notepad. And the next is the standard deviation, not the variance, but the standard deviation. And now we're ready to create our normalized variable. Press OK. And we're going to go look at our data set. There's a new variable that has been created. Now I'm going to show you the change in the distribution of these variables from step one to step two. I'm going to go to statistics. I'm going to look at skewness and kurtosis. And the charts, I'm going to look at the histogram showing the normal curve. Press OK. As you see, the first variable, the original variable, is terribly non-normal. We have a lot of outliers on the right hand side. And then we have this a result of step one, which is a nice uniform distribution. And now we have the normal distribution. That is the result of step two. What you will find in practice is probably not something this perfectly normal. You will probably find something with a what I call an inflated frequency, which would maybe a stack of zeros or a stack of, you know, ones or something like that somewhere in this distribution that will throw off the normality to some extent. But to look at this, look at the normality statistics on this particular variable. As we go from original to step one to step two, you can see that the skewness is terribly non-normal. This is horrifically non-normal. If you take the skewness and divide it by standard error of skewness, you get a terrible test value. This is kind of like a t-statistic, so you can kind of think of this as a 1.96, you know, plus or minus. This is way off, way over that amount. The fractional rank is zero skewness. That would be the uniform distribution, and the transform to normal would be zero skewness as well. Looking at kurtosis, horrific kurtosis with the original variable. Much improved kurtosis for the uniformly distributed, however, still significantly non-normal, and now normalized is much better. We have perfect normality according to these diagnostic tests. If you want to learn more about this transformation, I invite you to read my article on the subject, communications of the AAIS, or Association for Information Systems. This was published in 2011. This paper shows how to use the transformation in SPSS, Excel, and SAS. Here's the abstract, but probably important to you is this information, the details on the citation, so that you can go and find the article. If you have a problem finding the article, please don't hesitate to contact me. You can email me at this address. I would love to hear from you, in particular with the kinds of things you're doing with with the transformation and what kinds of approach, you know, methods such as components-based or covariance-based structural equation modeling, or you know, difference testing, anything that you're doing. It'd be very interesting to me to know what else other people are doing out there. Hope you find this approach to be useful to you.